Just before things kick off, I thought I would let everybody know we have a prize in this video. So, one lucky winner is going to have their choice of the American or German starter set for Konflikt 47. Get your comments in on Beasts of War, YouTube or Facebook for your chance to win.
From Viking halls to the cities of the future, terrain buffs will love our foreground hub. Watch gaming tables of all genres come to life at beastsofwar.com. Become a general of mighty armies at the Kings of War Hub. Take command of elves, dwarves, and orcs in this game of masked fantasy combat on beastsofwar.com.
Hi everybody, welcome to Let's Play Konflikt 47. As you can see, it's myself versus John. John, I'm sorry to say you're playing Weird World War today.
I know.
And this was actually tempting you.
I was trying to harangue Lloyd into it, but he was like, no, you need to like this stuff. You need to get in there and understand it. Plus, I'm busy, and just ran out of the room, and I was like, okay.
We are, of course, also joined by the mighty Chez himself. You'll remember him from the Bolt Action Locked and Loaded show. You're going to be basically teaching us how to play this, showing us where the differences are, and basically making sure that... our weird and wacky stuff does weird and wacky stuff.
Yeah, absolutely. So we're taking you guys through the two new starter sets for Konflikt 47. We've obviously already had a really good chat about what the actual background of this game is. So carries on from the great bolt action set of rules. There are a few extra bits and pieces in there. You can now do some reactions and things that we'll talk through in a bit. We've got a great little scenario to, and yeah, absolutely. We're talking about all the weird and wacky machinery you've got. That makes up pretty much 50% of your forces, so we'll definitely see some of that in play today.
Okay, so first things first, let's have a look at the table because we are running a scenario for this. Basically, in this world, the Soviets weren't allowed to have any of the new tech, so they've been stealing information, the sneaky gits.
Yep.
So on this tabletop, we have two dead drops, so one here and one here of stolen information, which both the Allies and the Germans have heard is in this area. So one of them is real, one of them's fake. Chez, you've decided which is real and which is fake.
I've got that written down.
So you will be telling us at the end of the show.
Yes.
Other than that, on my side, what we're seeing here is I have some Totten Corps here, my command squad of three guys here, regular Wehrmacht infantry, my Panzer X, another Wehrmacht infantry, and my little spider mech, my little spine mech, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. The spine is a light walker, so he can rush around the battlefield and ignore obstacles and cause havoc.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What have you got on your side of the table, John?
Right, over here, I'm fairly standard for my regular infantry, so I have an infantry unit down in here in some woods. I've got some armored heavy infantry over here, which I believe have got really nice weapons on them, but we'll come to that.
Yeah.
Got a light walker here who's got a couple of nice machine guns in there. Looking forward to that. Got a command group here. Got another section of American infantry. And over here, I have the biggest, weirdest thing here, which is a modified Sherman with a giant, what was it, a Tesla?
A Tesla cannon.
You have a Tesla cannon. I have a gravity cannon, essentially. Yeah. So it's going to be interesting to see how the new weapons work in the game.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So I'm thinking we just get stuck in and start playing.
Yeah, well, absolutely. I mean, in the time-honored tradition, we have the bag with one dice per unit. So for those of you who haven't seen it before, one order dice per unit on each side.
Yeah, yeah.
Different colours. An interesting note: there's one extra national characteristic in play in these for the Germans. That the Germans have a returning love for their fatherland. So units that want to advance can ignore a minus one on their modifier for when they take the test if they have any pins.
Ooh.
So that helps them. They're always going to try and move forward and regain the fatherland.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. Do I still have my NCO and loss of NCO promotion rule?
Yeah, the other ones are still in play, but that one's an additional one. And the Americans have plenty of equipment, plenty of ammunition. They're well fed. They're well supplied. So any team weapons, which you've got some LMGs and things in your infantry sections, you can reroll ones to hit. So that's a nice little breezy bonus for them.
Very nice.
So, you guys know the two objectives. You guys want to obviously take down your opponent's weird war mechs before they get to do anything to you. So then let's start it off with the first dice. And first up, we have black, which I'm assuming is the evil-hearted Germans.
Okay, so the first thing I'm going to activate is my Totten Corps, my zombies down here.
Absolutely.
Now, I believe these are slow chess. So what does that mean for us?
So new rule for them, slow infantry means they get to move 4 inches.
All right.
And a run of 8 inches. So very, very slow compared to regular.
I'm assuming because they're zombies, they don't get guns.
Correct. They are completely unarmored, but they do cause horror. They have this essence of fear around them whenever they get closer to the enemy. And yourself, so keep them away.
Okay, well, I think, what's the range on the horror? I just want to check
this. 6 inches.
So 6 inches. So down here, I have a squad that's quite close by, but hey, they're over 6 inches away, so they're not getting horrified. So I'm going to issue a run order.
Yep.
If I can find run.
Shambling run.
So they're going to run, and they're going to run straight up the table, 8 inches. So nothing subtle with these. It's just march forward and moan brains in German, I would assume. How do you say brains in German?
Good question.
Yeah, we don't know that.
Yeah, guys, comments below. I want to know how you say brains in German. Okay, so that'll be my first. I'll keep my order dice up with them.
Mm-hmm. And straight on to the next dice. All right, so we have a US.
A US dice, right. I'm going to shift my American infantry here down here.
Yeah, down in behind the forest?
Yeah, so I want to push them through the forest, try and start crossing this road and start mm-hmm. putting pressure onto these guys.
Okay.
So how am I going to move through my cover again?
So it's a regular, same as the bolt action ones, you cannot run through difficult terrain and wooded places like that. Okay. So you can advance 6 inches.
Yep, so I'll give them an advance order.
Okay.
And they'll move 6 inches, which should hopefully clear this hedgerow here. Which it does, so, and gets them about three quarters of the way across the road.
Yeah. It's worth mentioning at this point that the table layout we've got is a really beautiful looking World mm-hmm. War II setup with a lot of dense fields and things like that.
Yeah.
We're actually going to play the walled areas as regular obstacles, so uh-huh. you can't run over those. The hedgerows, because there's so many of them, we're just going to do them a soft cover, but we're not going to count them as obstacles themselves.
Yeah, so it's basically a soft row of hedges you can yeah. hide behind.
It's great looking from the top down, but... Mm-hmm. They're low enough. They've been all been cut back recently.
Yeah.
So you can just hop over them for your move.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. But all I'm right. assuming the forests do count as an obstacle as well, then.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Fine.
All right. So this infantry is now moved forward.
Yep.
I don't believe they are going to be able to shoot at anything at this point, even with an advance order. I think everything's okay. too much cover.
Yeah. Yeah.
Here,
absolutely. So. There's quite a few pieces.
Yeah. There. So okay. let's go move on.
Next dice out.
Aha.
It's another US.
Ooh, right. The Allies are feeling frisky this morning.
They are.
So what's going to activate?
I'm going to shift the Tesla tank, actually.
Ooh.
I'm going to shift the Sherman.
Okay.
Now, we've just said about terrain not really being that worrisome. Is that the same for the vehicles?
Well, the vehicles, the tanks, don't really mind rumbling over obstacles anyway.
Yeah.
So if you're doing an advance order, your 9-inch move, you can do your pivot at any point. Mm-hmm. You can pretty much ignore most of it. Don't obviously go through the ruins and yeah. that, but
yeah.
Now you're good to go. Now you do tote the strongest weapon in the game at this point. It's a +7 single shot. It's a focus beam from the Tesla. You can fire it at infantry as as an arced weapon.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
You know, if you can imagine the sparks going out. So it does do multiple hits on an infantry unit, but it's a lot less strong.
Yeah. Okay, so note to self, that dies first.
All right, so the tank's going to do an advance move. Mm-hmm. That's 9 inches, you said?
It is, yep.
Okay, so... From this position here, he's going to advance 9 inches to there.
Okay.
He's then going to bring his turret to bear.
Oh, no.
Because I see a light mech over here.
Yeah, there's a light mech away over here.
Yep, so let's move on and shoot with this guy, yeah?
Absolutely. Okay. So you're going to get one dice for the Tesla cannon itself.
Okay, mm-hmm. I'll move that to there.
Now, the Lightwalker counts as a vehicle mm-hmm. in terms of shooting, so you're going to use your stronger shot.
Yep.
Yep.
Your regular threes to hit, you've moved fours. Mm-hmm. Veteran vehicles, obviously, are a bit better for the Americans, yeah. but these guys are regular. Mm-hmm. And then you can take into account any to cover or anything like that, but I think it's a pretty open shot. You've moved it into a very nice open position.
Yeah, if we even check line, with a line
the
up there,
yeah.
there's nothing,
nothing interesting at all.
Nothing really in the way. I was hoping to actually get to activate that and get it behind the building quickly,
yes.
but oh well.
Well, you still got a 50-50 chance, so fours to hit.
Fours to hit.
And three. It's a three. There we go.
Okay.
So John's shooting with vehicles is the same as ever. Can't hit the broadside of a barn.
Absolutely.
That or my little spider mech just went, nope.
Next dice out. Nice. So the Germans can now react.
No, I don't need to worry about that Tesla tank, so I'm not going to activate my little spine mech yet. I'm actually going to activate my own tank, and I'll give it an advance order. So it'll advance 9.
Yep.
Which I have to admit, guys, looks amazing.
It does.
It looks like an all-powerful eye that's going to...
Yeah.
So I'm really
up to about here.
Yep.
If I can get it to sit. And its turret's going to... And get a shot on the front of John's tank.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this one obviously uses gravity technology. So the bigger and heavier the target, the more powerful it gets.
Yeah.
So in this case, it's an armor 9 vehicle. So you're going to get an additional +1 to your 4. So you're on a +5 penetration if
nice.
You hit.
Right.
So in the same respect as the other one, I think that it's a pretty much an open shot from there. So it's a 4s because you've moved.
Okay.
And this time we have a 6. Uh-huh. Huzzah.
Ta-da!
So we need to put a pin marker next to the Sherman.
Okay.
just to say that he's been hit.
Yeah. Yep. And I'll roll this back to one. Keep going. I'll
just... Yeah. And then you're on a +5 to penetrate, and you're on an armor 9. So you're looking for a 4 to do anything at all.
Oh, let's see what we get.
And we've got a 6 again!
Really?
So we've got a penetrating hit.
Okay,
so,
I'm putting this dice to the side.
Why would you do that? So penetrating hit, now you roll on the chart to see.
Okay.
And we're actually going to use the beautiful reference chart here. So okay, yeah. Roll your d6 and see how badly you've damaged it.
A 6!
Different
dice!
And that's a different dice.
Different dice!
So straight away the Tesla turret has been blown clean off, the crew are dead. Explosions everywhere. That just goes to show that... you made the first move with the tank, got it out in the open. Your shot didn't work.
Yeah.
You came back with a boom.
See, this is one of the things I've always discovered. Because this place is similar to Bolt Action, those threat assessments work the same.
Exactly.
You know, because I had wanted to get my little spine mech into cover first. It was a tempting target for John. He went for it.
Mm-hmm.
And now I've been able to hit that while it's out in the open.
Yeah, absolutely. You know,
so I've caught him in the weeds. Sorry, John.
This dice comes across, and that's a...
Huzzah!
A victory point, per se.
Yes, yes.
Okay, right, next on, you better get some something back. Now, obviously your threat to that tank is limited. You do have the heavy machine gun, which possibly pin, but not damage, so you might need to think carefully about that tank from now on.
Yeah.
Although, obviously, it's only good against armoured vehicles, so your light, your walker definitely has to be more careful.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Interesting choices.
Interesting choices. I would like to move this heavy infantry unit now down here. Mm-hmm. Is their movement just the same as regular infantry, or are they slower?
Yeah, well, it's worthwhile probably looking at the reference of those, because they are brand new units.
I believe they're marked as large infantry.
Heavy infantry, I think they are. Yeah, heavy infantry squad. So they are veterans, but instead of being 5s to wound, they're 6s, because they're resilient. And they've got infrared, and they're tank hunters with their grenades. So they're actually interesting. Yeah. So they don't need to take the minus test to go in on the tanks. Mm-hmm. So they're pretty good for those. But their movement isn't affected.
Right.
The technology is so good that, you know, the weight of it doesn't slow them down.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, I'd like to issue a run order with them.
Okay. Okay, so then that's what you should do. So as long as you don't go over an obstacle, you're fine. So the low hedges are good, just not the walled area in front of you.
Yeah, and I assume they can just jump straight over this little barrier here.
Through it, they'll be honest.
They'll just
smash it into kindling, yeah.
Lovely cinematic moment of them going, what's this? A checkpoint? No.
All right, so...
Sorry.
To run, then, would be a 12-inch move.
It is, yeah. Double move, so...
I think I just want to guarantee them getting up to this wall here, so...
Yeah,
so that's so easily done. That's 11 inches to get to there,
yep.
That's where they're going.
Line them ready to go for next turn.
So they've spotted some zombies shambling across the field and are now going, gentlemen, line up, load up, and let's rock and roll.
Yeah, remember, absolutely. Boys, don't get too close.
Yeah. Okay, next up is another American, so a couple in a row.
I'm worried about the light mech now. I know he's fired, but still.
Yeah. Right, quick question. Can you go into ambush in this game with a light mech?
You can, but obviously if you don't get the movement in front of you, ambush only works against something that moves in front of you. So if he's already got a shot on you, he won't activate his ambush if you fire your tank next turn. So
yeah,
the positioning and hiding from that panzer might be far more important.
Yeah. Right, well, the light mech then, I think he's going to try and shift across here.
Yep.
Okay.
So he's going to cross the road.
Absolutely.
He can move
9.
9, yeah. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, he can move just fine, issuing his advance order.
Yep, and he's got some really neat little rules for going across obstacles and terrain as well. He can actually walkers, unless the obstacle is designed to stop walkers, if you imagine giant, even bigger dragon's teeth and things like that. He can just ignore obstacles. So he can walk across and go across the walls and things. Mm. He's a huge robot. Why would
he's advanced himself into a bit of cover.
Fantastic stuff. Next up is a German unit.
Okay. I think the next thing I'm going to activate is actually my little regular guys here.
Yeah.
And I'm going to give them an advance order. So actually, no, I'm going to give them a run because I want to get them up into cover. So 12 inches.
12 inches, not going across a wall or anything.
So I can get up to here.
Yep.
So I'm just going to move them all up to here, and that should be fine.
Again, just like your the Americans at the back, the Germans needed the run order to get further and as close to the wall as possible ready for next time. So
it is a viable option to actually issue a run order just to make sure you get to cover, because cover is such an important aspect of the game.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Don't want to get caught in the open.
Run.
Next dice up is another German unit.
Okay. This time I'm going to activate my little... I'm going to activate my Spine Mac.
Yep.
And if I issue a run order for it, how far does it go?
So it can still double, and obviously your movement is slightly restricted, but only over big ruins. So don't run across the big ruins.
No.
Else it can
no. I have an idea of where I need to get this now.
Absolutely.
So I'm going to issue the run order.
18 to wherever you need.
And it's going to basically
bound
blitz
across
it.
The field. Boing, boing.
Boing, 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 boing.
Yeah.
To here. Because I get the feeling that this might be very useful against John's heavy infantry, which are up at that wall. So I'm hopeful that that might do the job, especially with that nice big movement. I can maybe start flanking him.
Yeah, absolutely. Now this is where the mech off will come in, like Meg. So the heavy machine gun can definitely take down this one, but obviously it's got an autocannon and a light anti-tank gun itself. So risky times ahead. Mm-hmm. Next up is another German unit.
All right, so this time I'm going to activate my command squad, and they are here. So it's just these three little guys here. I'm going to activate them. I'm going to issue a run order, and I'm going to have them just... Well, actually, no, I can just give them an advance.
Yep.
And I'll have them advance up behind the vehicle.
Behind the vehicle, yeah. Obviously, again, vehicles, so you can go as long as you're an inch away, so don't tuck them too close. You can use vehicles in bolt action like hardcover, mobile hardcover. And it's definitely, I think we actually did a video on it, and going up and using that mobile.
You and Chez did this one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, Americans, what have you got left, guys?
We have a command group and another section of infantry. Mm-hmm. So this section over here, I think we're just going to give them an advance.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
And they're just going to tuck themselves up to this hedge.
Yep. Now, you've got a lot of firepower coming here, so you're setting yourself up for the next couple of turns. It's important to give yourself clear lines of fire, which you've done. I mean, the Sherman being knocked out is a bad thing, but you can still now line up and just tuck in front of it and use those lanes to your advantage.
Mm-hmm. Honestly, I do have to admit, that was lucky me rolling 3 sixes in a row to actually take the Sherman out. Yes. You know, it's damn near unheard of.
Yep.
You save. You're a pretty lucky roller. I've seen you before.
There are times when I roll good and times when I roll bad. Okay.
Okay. Two dice left in the bag.
Yep.
Next one is the German. So there's one unit left at the back.
So I'm going to issue just an advance order to my last unit, which is back here. So advance. And I'll advance them just right up behind this little set of barricades. Now, I assume I can't hop over this next turn, yeah? Because of what they are.
Yeah, absolutely. They're deliberately designed to stop infantry in their tracks.
So, yeah. So they're just moving up to there because things are getting a little bit crowded. And then I'm hoping next turn, everything else will move out of the way and these guys can activate and basically get out of the road.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully before something of John activates and gives them a little smack in the face.
And last but not least will be the American final. Mm-hmm.
These guys are just going to do an advance because they're going to get up tighter into this building, I think.
I like it. So they're going to get themselves some firing positions.
Yep.
Yeah. So in some nice hard cover in the ruin.
Yep. Oop. Absolutely.
And one man falls from the top.
He wants to fly away.
Yep.
And we'll just make sure that everyone can see.
Fantastic.
So that's all we're going to do with them.
Okay.
Exactly. Okay.
Excellent.
So that's all the dice out of the bag. So that's the end of turn one. So anybody that isn't on an ambush or a down is allowed to.
Yep.
Oops, well, has to put straight back in.
Mm-hmm.
So assessments from the first turn, you both made advances towards the objectives.
Yeah.
But I think...
First blood to the Germans.
First blood to the Germans. That's a pretty big blow. So it'll be interesting to see how you come back from that.
Yeah, I'm actually a little disappointed because I really wanted to see what the Tesla tank could do against infantry.
You want to see it, but you also don't want to feel it. So
we're playing a game at the end of the day.
Yeah, absolutely, Okay, first dice of turn two is the German unit.
So... the first thing, my Totten Corps are going to run again.
Absolutely. They're shambling forward to try and overwhelm.
I cannot leave these guys just hanging out in the middle of nowhere. So 8 inches is going to take them just up to the ruins.
Yeah. So it gives them a bit of cover in terms of being able to shoot at them. They do, when you're rolling to wound them, they do count as inexperienced. They do die in droves.
So having a little bit of hard cover around them, I think, is going to be a wise idea. And hopefully that means next turn I can maybe see about getting a zombie charge on the go. which could be interesting. Because I'm wondering what they do in melee as well.
Well, they're zombies. They'll probably just flail and dribble and do all the weird stuff on you.
But I'll assume they're super cheap then.
Yeah, oh, they are. They're only like 7 points each. But like inexperienced troops in combat, they don't fare too well, especially against veterans. Don't forget, you're looking at the hardest infantry that's ever graced a battlefield so far in this. So you'll be on sixes to
injury. Well, they're just a distraction. They're cannon fodder.
Exactly. Okay, next dice out is an American unit.
So all right.
This what are we thinking?
Section over here is going to advance. Because they're going to get across this hedge and they're going to take up firing positions.
Absolutely. Okay. Now, the great thing about the Americans is, as with all of their fire and maneuver orders, they don't get the minus one for moving. So you're pretty much always likely to want to advance and take up a better position. Yeah. And if you can get to within 12 inches, obviously you're in short range.
Yeah.
You're taking those modifiers away from being harder to hit. So.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, hop them all across. They're all fine.
Yeah.
They don't block each other's line of sight, so that's great.
Yeah.
And now you're working out, I'm assuming they're going to open fire.
Yeah, of course, they are, certainly.
Funnily enough, absolutely. Right, so work out, you're going to get one per carbine or rifle. You're going to get a couple of dice if anybody's got an SMG, and then three dice for your LMG.
Yeah. So as far as I know, the makeup of the squads is LMG, everyone else has a carbine.
Okay. Yep.
But with the LMG, it's a team, so you'll lose one of your carbines.
So take three dice for the LMG, because you roll those as a separate colour, so we'll now that they've got their special rule.
Yep.
And then you've got five other guys, six other guys, in fact, got an eight-man squad.
Oh, right, it's an eight-man squad.
Yep.
Six. Yep.
So there we go. So you're on threes, basic. The LMG will get the minus one for moving, but and you're also in hardcover. So it's sixes to hit for the LMGs, and with the hardcover it'll be fives for everything else.
All right.
And but looking for ones possibly for a reroll using your plenty supply.
Yeah. Okay.
Supply.
All right.
That's not bad. A couple of hits there with the carbines and rifles.
Fives. Yeah, yeah.
And what do we get on the?
I think one LMG got in.
Five. I think it was sixes.
Six for that one. So no, just the two hits from that. But that's all right.
It is a pin onto my zombies.
Yep. Well.
And the ones don't count for the rifle shot.
Correct. No, it's just for the team weapons. Yeah. And then two rolls to wound for your your hits so far.
Okay. Yep.
And there
four
we go.
Two
dead.
Six.
Two dead.
So I'm gonna take the two guys from the back.
Yep. Now you'll like this. Again, I'll pull up the reference because it's a brand new unit. So let's try and find the totem corpse, because this is quite funny. I do like this.
Okay.
So we have the totem corpse cards. They are obviously, we've talked about horror, tough, which means you get two dice.
Oh.
And on a 5+, you ignore the wound because it might just shot a limb off and they carry on.
Okay. So,
there we go. So you roll 1-5. So one of them gets shot on the leg, just
falls down and just gets back up again. So, muttering brains in German.
Absolutely. Now, the funny thing is, you ignore pin markers and all morale checks for these things.
All right.
Keep it on there just in case for future reference for bits and pieces.
Yeah.
But they don't need to take
tests
and things like that. So
okay, that makes a lot of sense because a zombie, they're not going to duck down, take cover when they're under fire.
Yeah.
It doesn't concern them.
Lunches that way, gents. Let's go.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So, yeah, really, really cool little. Yeah, and that's why they're a tiny bit more expensive than regular inexperienced infantry. They're offering a whole lot more on the table. These. Again, we're talking about the toughest super fighters that they've seen. These guys have never been seen on the battlefield until this point, and they are horrible.
Yeah.
Can you imagine the shooting these guys and they just keep getting back up again? Limbs missing, blood everywhere. It would be a sight to behold. So let's try and take them out, I suppose.
Okay,
German. Unless the Germans react first. So.
Oh, where do I want to go with this now? I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to issue... I'm going to issue an advance order to my tank...
Sure.
Because I want to just have it in the middle of this field. You know, it's done its job, it's going to here, and it's just going to sit there now as a bit of a, you know, just a way for the guys to actually have a bit of cover when they run through here, something to hide behind.
Yep.
But other than that, I can still take a shot because I only advanced.
Correct.
Yeah. So, actually, I've put the right face of the dice up just to keep it marked properly. So, I can't see your mech, but I will... Take a single shot at your super heavy infantry.
Yeah, sure.
Because I think that could be amusing.
There is an added bonus with the anti-grav weapons. It does basically slow down a unit. So you might only be trying to take out one guy, but it may slow them for the next turn. The effect of the gravity is not just crushing them, crumpling them. It actually makes it harder for them to move forward.
All right.
So it's definitely worth having a go at something you think is...
Well, that's something. Now that I know that, these guys I don't really expect to move. Okay. However, if I turn around here, I do expect these guys to do a bit of moving. So I'll take that shot at them.
Sounds good.
So, four to hit.
Yeah, you've advanced. Oh, they're in soft cover, so it'll be fives, yeah.
Okay.
Six. And another six, so that weapon's a continuing its barrage
of
sixes.
That tank is on fire. Superior German technology, Mr. Lance.
Absolutely. And it's on a plus four.
Uh-huh.
Now, the gravity pulse, so that unit will not be able to be given a run order in its next go.
Right,
be hit by that. So see if you kill one on a two plus, because there's a squishy infantry from this thing.
Two.
So there we go. One of them goes down.
I'll assume it's just regular trooper.
Yep. It certainly will be, because you didn't roll a six.
Yep. So, and second pin?
First pin.
First pin.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Because the tank they got.
Oh, yes.
Absolutely. So they now cannot issue a run order.
Yeah. Mm.
So quite important, that weapon, in terms of what it can do.
It's a bit of crowd control built into it.
Yeah, you see, that's what I was thinking at the start of this game. I knew that was going to be decent for against any armored vehicles. Yeah. I didn't realize it had that sort of extra option, like what the Tesla tank has.
Yes. Again, it's not really, you wouldn't choose to shoot an infantryman over a vehicle with the strength of the weapon.
Yeah, but whenever the vehicles are dead, it gives it a use, and it still keeps it a threat.
Perfect. Right. Okay. Americans, what are you going to do?
I don't want to be within 6 inches of these guys.
They affect the minus one on your morale at any point. If you don't need to take morale,
it doesn't matter.
Then it doesn't really matter.
Right.
But don't get caught in positions where you're getting pinned and they're close by.
So they're
definitely a threat.
Mm-hmm. Well, since these guys have already shot, these guys are going to advance.
Sure.
Okay.
And they're going to get in.
Okay.
I think.
Now, I'm going to make one assumption. Mm-hmm. Even though I have my totem core up here in the objective, I'm assuming they can't take the objective. Because let's be honest, a zombie is not going to be smart enough to go, papers. Yeah. Must bring them back to HQ.
I don't think it's just necessarily about them opening the box and doing it. It's about controlling the space. So they can definitely stop any enemy from getting close as well. So they're definitely important to clear off.
So these guys could advance over the wall, right?
They can advance over the wall, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
So they can't engage them in combat, but they can certainly get to point-blank range.
Yep.
So stop an inch away at most, but you're more like you're a couple of inches away anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So now you're within six. You're giving yourself every chance of hitting with everything.
Yes. And I'm expecting much death, because it looks as if these guys are toting around souped-up assault rifles.
There they are. Yeah, they're absolutely. They count as assault rifles for in terms of the number of dice and the range and everything. So they are certainly great.
Mm. Okay.
Now, they're only real viable target. Are obviously the totem core in front of them.
Yep.
So two dice per man.
Okay. 10 dice.
Okay.
Three's basic. Up to fives because the zombies are in and around the ruins.
Yep.
But you're at point blank, so you're down to fours. So as good as you're going to get. So fours to hit.
Alrighty.
And then killing on threes. Wow.
Oh, wow. That hurts. That.
Two misses. Three.
I think you've got like five hits
four.
There.
Five hits,
ouch. Yep. And then threes to kill.
Mm-hmm.
Well, obviously you get your ability to shrug it off, but very good. Four rolls, please, Justin. See if those...
Yeah, you see, this is what happens whenever the elite guys walk up. They've probably already seen the totem core before and just are turning to the other guys shouting, look, you shoot them in the head, like this.
Yeah, absolutely.
Two of them saved.
Nice.
Yep.
So, not bad.
Not bad.
So, two more die. I'll take them from the back.
They are whittling down the numbers pretty quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but I can sort of live with that, because they're not shooting at other stuff, and it's giving me time to get into position.
You're not even alive. How can you live with it?
They can grumble with that.
They would get one more pin.
Just for...
Just for record keeping.
Yep. Mm-hmm. So, next up, let's keep the flow going.
All right. I don't like this tank. I really don't like this tank.
Yeah. Well, you see, the unfortunate thing is, now that this tank is just sitting here in a commanding area of the table, your mech down the back is kind of just going, don't like.
Yeah, you're keeping this out of the way.
Which is a HMG, or is it an MMG?
It's both. It's got an MMG on its arm and an HMG on its shoulder, and it's a one-man walker, so you choose which weapon system you want to use each turn.
Yeah.
So go for the extra dice or go for the extra penetration.
Mm-hmm. I might issue a run order. to the Mac.
Really?
Why not?
Interesting.
It's ignoring essentially every bit of cover.
Pretty much, yeah. You don't run through the woods.
Yep.
But you can certainly hop over the smaller obstacles and things like the infantry stopping ones here. Mm. They can just ignore. They just step over them.
Why do I have the horrible feeling that it's going to run to here and then next turn try for a charge and actually try and tear my tank a new one?
Oh.
Because it does have melee, doesn't it?
With that? Yeah. Yep, so up to 18. So
up to 18. And it can move freely during the
run. Yeah, absolutely.
It's not like a tank. Oh dear.
It's not like a tank. It doesn't have facings.
I may have done goofed.
Well, I'm not sure. I don't think there's a lot you can do about that. But
18.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. The interesting thing about, because walkers fall in between vehicles and infantry, their armor is all around them. They don't have a rear facing when it comes to being shot at. Mm-hmm. So that's quite important. And they're very maneuverable.
Yeah. So yeah, you can definitely make it up to there. Oh, right. You're just standing behind the cover?
There's no point in assaulting you when I'm running.
There is.
Is there?
If you're charging into assault...
If you can make it, you can assault it now. Yeah, of course. It's you have to do it with a run order.
Yeah. You've now assaulted me with that, which has two power fists.
Yeah.
Yep.
So you might be about to rip my shiny new turret off.
Yeah, indeed. So now, pretty early on, well, again, it's a brand new thing. So what we'll do is we'll pull up the section for walkers assaulting other vehicles.
Yes. This is something that I find interesting, is the fact that walkers can assault other vehicles.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. It's they're designed, these guys have given over a lot of firepower, whereas the German...
I've still got a light anti-tank gun on here.
Exactly.
I assume I don't have that extra in melee, because
don't have any fists at all in there. What you've given up in terms of your anti-tank, you've got in raw power.
Yes, in raw, rip shirts and off, rip tracks off, rip commander out of hatch.
So yeah, they're not built for they're not built for collisions. They don't run in and just ram them. They go in and they
grab
rip
on.
Apart and grab.
So are you gonna flip the tank?
Yeah. That could make an. I just as a modeler, I just went, that could make an awesome diorama.
Yes.
Having one of those running up to the side of that and just pulling the shirts in off and taking bits out of the turret.
Honestly, I just have images of it going and just flipping my lovely Panzer Axe over on its back.
So target can react as normal, in which case you've already worked. Acted this turn, so there's nothing you can do about it.
Yeah.
Once in contact, target, you roll a d6 for both the walker and the vehicle. So you're both rolling a dice. Now, the walker gets +1 if it's a higher damage value, but it's not. But it does get -1 because you're a higher.
Okay.
But you're going to be getting extra because of your fists. That's...
Yes, and you have two fists.
Yeah.
This is what happens whenever
brand new. I just want to make sure I get it right for you.
No, that's perfect. I like that we're going to make sure this works well, because I like the cinematic idea that we're just having a bit of a bust up here.
Yeah.
You know,
so the walker rolls an additional dice for each fist it's equipped with.
Two.
Two extra. You've got two fists. So you're rolling three dice, and you're rolling one dice. You do get +1.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you're now basically looking for the highest dice roll. So. Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's see how...
Three.
So three.
Not so good. Six.
So your six goes down to a 5, but you've still penetrated. So you've won the combat, yeah.
Yeah. Now, is that just one attack with three dice, or is it three attacks?
It's three attacks. So this one does not go through, but these two do.
Yeah.
So you've got two penetrating hits on it, and then you resolve as you would do on the
damage chart.
So roll two dice.
Okay.
That was... quite powerful.
No.
One and a two. That's fine. You've kind of set it on fire and immobilized it and done all sorts of funny stuff. So
basically, you've ran around, lifted the engine bay, and went, oh, that looks important. Dunk.
Yeah.
So we're taking the best one of these. So you get a pin, and you take an extra pin for being immobilized. A part of the, it's very, very apt, part of the vehicle's tracks and wheels have been ripped off. The vehicle cannot move for the rest of the game. So I know you wanted it as a pillbox, but now you have no choice in that. So you can't really...
Yeah, but I still have the coyote standing right next to me about, you know, just pulling back for the second shot.
Yeah, absolutely.
That has to die.
It has to die. Okay.
Well, that was all right.
Yes.
I still haven't taken it out, but I've made it aware that I'm annoyed at it.
Yes, and if you get the first dice next turn, I assume you're just going to do the same again directly.
Hopefully.
Because otherwise, the commander in my tank's going to go, what was that?
If he passes
point blank
his test.
Yeah.
Because you're now obviously under a huge amount of stress being pinned and everything.
Yeah.
So nothing's automatic.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. Right, next out is a German one.
Interesting choices now. Because I want to activate this little guy, and my options are I can either go after your Mac, or I can go after your infantry. I think I'm going to just do an advance. Or can I see them from here?
I know, because you can't shoot through your own units.
Yeah. So, I'm just going to advance 9 inches.
Yep.
Out to here.
Bounding across and over, and kicking things away. Yep. I just love the idea. It comes with this whole, you know, War of the Worlds feeling of huge walkers striding across landscapes.
I don't know. You see, that particular one, I kind of have a sort of a grasshopper flea motion in mind, where it's nice. Jumping across the battlefield. Like, boink, boink,
dunk. Yeah, I'm not sure the suspension is up to that, but hey, why not?
All right, so from there, I'm now going to take a shot. Actually, I'm going to take a shot at these guys.
Sure. Mm-hmm. So
I'm going to give them hardcover because there is this wall in the way. You know, so I assume that will be right next to the hedge.
Well, it's from your gun down to the thing. So I only give them soft cover from there, to be honest. They're not really? Directly behind the wall. Yeah, absolutely. From where you are.
I would definitely give it hard cover.
You're very nice. You're very nice. Go on then.
Always play fair. So hard cover. I've moved. So that's sixes. I'm going to fire the, not the light anti-tank gun, the other weapon.
That's my cannon. So you got two shots.
Okay, two shots.
Yep. And so sixes. Base of threes. Yep. Sixes for the hard cover.
There's
another one. So he's continuing his roll of sixes for those. And you are on plus two, so twos to kill one.
Twos to kill one?
Yep.
Okay. So one guy dies, and they take a pin.
They certainly do. Mm-hmm. So take off a carbine totem guy and...
Yep.
Chuck a pin down.
Indeed. Mm-hmm. Now again, I haven't managed to use it yet, but there are reactions you can do if you haven't acted this turn. I'll point them out to you when they happen.
Yeah.
It doesn't always just...
Well, I'm sure we'll get to a point here where we are breaking out the entrenching tools.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And not for entrenching.
These guys are going to advance.
Okay.
I think.
Is that because they're not allowed to run? Yeah. No, they're just, I'm sure they would. Yeah.
They're just happy to advance.
Okay.
Just happy to be doing something.
Crossing the road.
Mm-hmm.
And up to the wall.
Yep. So we're just going to get ourselves into some cover here.
Mm-hmm. Really feels like World War II when you're hedge hopping and wall hopping and going between the stuff. It's like you know all those films that run across and
But we've still got all the really cool Weird World War stuff in this, but it still feels like the game I know and love, which is what I'm really enjoying about this.
Mm. Oh, okay, so before you do that, you need to roll two dice against your command. So they're regular, so they're nine.
Yep.
And the plus and the minus one cancel, so nine or less on two dice to be able to follow through that order. Yeah, and you're on eight, so they're fine. So they lose one pin marker.
Yep.
And they carry out the order that you've just done. Yep. Rather than rewind. But you must remember that. Now you're starting to get pins, you don't automatically follow through your orders. Just like bolt
action. Any shooting because you've advanced, John?
No.
Because there are some stuff here.
You've probably got a very tough shot. You might as well take it.
Up here?
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
It's definitely going to be... Well, you don't get the minus for moving with your carbines.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So now, in this case... If you're going to take the shot, you're allowed to react. So you can pull your dice out.
Uh-huh.
On a 2d6 roll, using any morale modifiers and stuff like that, you can do a couple of things. If you're within 20, which it looks like you are, you can do a firefight.
Okay.
So you can return fire, and it's simultaneous.
Okay, well, there's 20 inches there, so we're well within that.
So, but what that does is that would draw your dice out of the bag for this turn and force them to do that firefight. So if you want to engage them in a firefight, you're more than welcome to try. Or you can just, if you've got another plan for them, I'd probably wait.
Actually, I want to see how this works, so I'll try for pulling my dice out the bag.
So, 2d6 roll,
yep.
And you're on a 10 or less, because you've got your command section right next to you.
Okay,
and so that's passed.
9.
Mm-hmm. So perfect. You pull out your dice, put it onto a fire order.
Lovely.
Simultaneous shooting, so you can both work out your numbers of dice, even though you do it one at a time.
Yeah.
It counts. It doesn't matter how
many dice. Okay, so I've got a light machine gun on my side, which will be my white dice.
Yep, and you actually get 4.
I don't have a fourth white dice. Can I borrow one of John's red?
You may.
Thank you. Okay. And then I've got 8 more guys with rifle.
Yep.
So I'm hoping this is the correct choice.
Sounds pretty good to me. And then the Americans are going to have...
They've lost one guy.
Yep. So you're going to have 5 guys with rifles.
Mm-hmm. And an LMG.
And an LMG.
Yep.
Okay, so the LMG is 3.
Yep.
Yep.
And then one dice for each of them, so 5 others.
Five guys,
I am assuming my LMG doesn't get to re-roll its ones because I've got the Hitler's buzzsaw instead.
Yeah, you've got the extra dice. The Americans have got the plentiful ammo. So, okay, let's do this one person at a time, so make sure we get it right. Okay. So the Germans they're all at long range.
Yep.
But
haven't moved.
They haven't moved, but there is hard cover in the way. So they're going to be on 5 to hit.
Okay.
So we'll do that one first.
One dice.
Edge.
Okay, so I've got 1, 2, 3, 4,
5 hits.
5.
That's pretty nasty. Mm-hmm. And then the Americans, now they're going to be, they don't get the minus one for moving.
Yep.
So you basically both count as being stationary.
Yeah.
And I believe they're all at long range as well. So same roll.
So that'll be three back. One. No, four back.
Yep. It's worth noting, actually, the LMG would get the minus one, but they are in shorter range for the LMG. So yeah. It's still the same roll.
Yeah.
But yeah, the LMG, must remember the LMG does get the minus one for moving.
Yep.
So four versus five. Now you're both rolling to wound. You're both regular infantry.
All right.
Go ahead.
Fours to wound, guys. And you both take a pin marker as well, obviously, from this.
So I've got four wounds.
Ooh, four wounds. See. Against
two.
Now you've both rolled sixes there, so don't forget to re-roll to see if you get any special
exceptional
damage.
Six.
Yes.
Do I roll both of these?
You roll both of yours to see if you get a six, and you've both got exceptional damage. So you both choose one of those casualties from each other. So you've either got one of the LMG, so you can knock out the LMG if you want, or you can knock out the NCO.
Now the NCO, what's the bonus there?
The NCO will mean he's on minus one morale for the rest of the game. Whereas if he knocks out your NTO, you've got a chance of replacing him.
Yeah.
So the German training.
I think, in all honesty, John, the way this game's going to go, I'm just going to knock out that LMG because it's taking out a fair amount of damage.
Yep.
So technically, I'm only taking two dice out of the squad because the other guy
still got a rifle.
Who has a comes back with his rifle. Yeah.
Yep.
So take out your LMG, please.
Right. Just take this guy out.
Yep. Take that guy out.
There we go. And obviously, don't forget your pin marker.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And I think you took another casualty. How was it? Three total? Four?
Four
total. So another three guys, I'm afraid.
Ouch.
So NCO. You're going to be left with an NCO and a couple of guys.
Yep.
And
which would you like to kill from my side, John?
I'm taking your LMG.
That's well.
Okay.
Where is my LMG?
That was some pretty brutal firefighting game in there. So that just going to show if you did not reacted. You would have lost your LMG for no comeback.
Yeah. Okay, that'll be my LMG.
But you reacted.
Then.
So, okay, so you've both taken a pin.
Yeah.
In your case, you've taken half casualties in one go. So it does, even though it's your turn, I'm afraid it was your shot, you still take a test. So two
I
dice.
I quite like this idea. It feels more interactive when you're shooting at each other.
It is, yeah. I mean, it already was interactive one dice at a time, but this really makes you think about, do I just open up for no reason? Now, you are close to your HQ, which is a plus one, and you still get your NCO. So, again, going through the motions, they're there. Regular command of 9, down to an 8, back up to a 9.
Okay.
And they're fine.
Yep, they like it.
You say fine, you've killed most of them. So, not as fine as they
well,
were.
Well, you see, this was the thing I was balancing out whenever I was deciding, do I want to shoot or not? Because I looked at it, my unit's bigger.
Yep.
The shot's going to be roughly the same. Absolutely. I should, in theory, do more damage.
Yeah. But they are now pinned, and they've worked for this turn, so there you've kept them further away. So, you know, it's not all a downside.
It is a balancing act,
And he had to make that test in the first place.
Yeah.
So, great example of the firefight.
Yeah.
Okay, next dice out is another German unit.
Okay, so for my next trick, I'll activate this squad here. They're just going to get an advance order, if I find advance. And they're just going to advance right up into the ruins here.
Yeah.
So... if we can just assume that they are hiding in and amongst the ruins here.
Sure. So they're definitely... the German right flank and the American left flank are...
carouseling a little
bit.
Yeah. But
the Americans are definitely good on their right flank, see?
I'm hoping that my little light mech will make all of the difference. So bring their dice with them. And that will be that for me.
Fantastic stuff. So next one out, you've both got your... command sections left, I believe. So, Americans.
Yep.
Now, obviously, you probably do need to add some firepower into the fight.
Yep.
So, you are at an elevated position. So, in this case, you can shoot over the top of your infantry. They're over an inch above them, so that's fine. Yeah. And you're within your command radius. So, it's a pretty good position at the moment.
Yep. Well, I'm just going to issue a fire order from this unit, and they're going to fire at the guys that have moved up.
Guys in the ruins. So, you're at long range, and they're in hard cover, so you're going to be on sixes.
So these ones, and I assume I don't get to react now because my dice is already out of the bag,
Yeah.
So it's four shots from these guys, or is it three because this guy's down a level?
I think, it'll be three shots.
Yeah.
So, because they're on the elevated, and...
Let me just make a quick check here.
Yeah.
That's your HQ section.
Yes.
Generally, I always thought HQs, it was commander and two guys that could be taken. Has that now changed?
No, I'm not sure where the fourth guy is. Is he hiding away? Was he left behind from the other squad?
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, he's probably been left behind.
Yeah.
Let's put him across there.
Sorry.
Still a good spot.
I wanted to check that because I was looking at it going, wait a minute, there's four in that command squad. Yeah. That doesn't seem right to me.
No, it's always good. I didn't see him hiding in the ruins yet. So always make sure you take all your figures with you when you move infantry sections. So still would have been, you still lost four, so it doesn't affect anything.
Yeah, okay, so three shots.
Looking for sixes.
Nope.
No team weapon in there, so you don't get to reroll the one. So I'm sorry about that. Mm-hmm. Not so good.
Worth the shooting, though. Okay, so my last one.
What do
I have left? Oh, my command squad. My command squad, I'm just going to give them an advance.
Yep.
This, and they're just going to quickly pop up right into here.
Securing the right flank.
Secure the right flank and just make sure that this unit has a bit of support from the command structure.
Yeah.
Which I think is the best way to do this.
Right.
Absolutely. So there we go. Turn two over and done with already. Mm-hmm. I think that turn, definitely the Americans came back with a huge number of pins, if you can have a look around.
I'm pinned here, here, and here.
Yep.
John, you're only pinned there.
Here and here.
And there,
But, and I have a few casualties on the American side, but definitely not one side in that turn.
Yeah. All right. Well, here, I'll tell you what. Let's just take a quick break, and we'll have a little think about what we want to do next. So we'll be back in a second.
Fight for the Iron Kingdoms as a Warcaster. Take control of the mighty Jacks, arcane devices, and dark sorceries to bring the fight to the War Machine Hub on beastsofwar.com. Humanity has been driven from Earth, but now it's time to take it back. Join the Reconquest and fight the Scourge on the Drop Zone Commander Hub at beastsofwar.com.
Okay, guys, we are back for turn three of the double objective game. It's been a bit of a bloodbath so far, John.
Yeah, it's been interesting. Yeah.
I am really enjoying the rules so far. Mm-hmm. You know, they're very, very clean.
Yeah.
Chez, who's going first?
So, yeah, straight up to the next one. Next one out is Americans.
Sweet. Oh, damn.
What you gonna do?
Right. Well, there's plenty of options.
Yeah. Well, your current options are, you can either try and clear my Totem Corp here, try and get my mech, maybe.
Yeah.
You could try and get my tank
continue
out of the way.
The fighting there, yeah.
You could try and shoot these guys, but we have seen the reaction rules, and that's a full squad, so it becomes a little risky.
Yeah. Yep. You've also got two units with pin markers on them, so you'd have to actually roll dice. You may actually just go down and not do anything at all. So doing something without pins is always a good option.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right. Well, then I'm going to make these guys run.
Okay.
Okay.
Now, a run option to do what? Are they going to engage the zombies?
Because no.
You can't run through rubble or anything like that.
They're going to skirt this rubble.
Okay.
And they're going to go for this mag.
Okay. So you're coming out and around?
Okay, so an assault roll you do as a direct line from where you are to where they are.
Right.
So at this point, I would probably say that that's not an option for them.
Okay.
Because you have to go through. So I'm afraid the zombies are doing what the zombies do and getting in the way and doing all sorts of stuff. So. Yeah. I'm afraid it's clear them out or...
Yeah, it is clear them out. So we're just going to issue a fire order then.
Okay.
It's good to spot. I mean, even though they're the juicier target behind them, he's obviously worried about you shooting them down.
Yeah.
The zombies are really in his way. The rubble's in his way. So clearing them out of that. So, I mean, clearing them out in close combat is definitely an option if you wanted to do that.
All right then. So we'll do a...
Do an assault.
Assault.
Now, you're on minus one because you're within six, but you don't need to take a test. So that minus one doesn't actually affect you this time. So that's pretty cool. So the horror of
they just move in here then.
So you're well within six,
Right, lads, break out the spades, hit them in the head.
Yes.
Oh, this is gonna hurt.
So put them all in.
Yeah,
all good.
Yeah.
Just mess myself in here.
Yeah.
Yeah, I assume everybody's in.
Now, we've got some simultaneous fighting going here because you're in and around the obstacles. So there are five zombies, I do believe, so get five dice.
Okay.
And you've got assault rifle toting heavy infantry, so you've got 10 dice.
Mm.
So this should be a bit of a bloodbath. So
my poor little zombies, they were hungry. They just wanted some lunch today.
Resilient soldiers, I'm afraid. You're going to need sixes to wound him.
So,
because they're heavy infantry.
And
with all that armor.
The zombies just get squished, so you need three.
Yeah, so basically my zombies are trying to find the chinks in the armor where they can actually get a snack.
Absolutely. So this might be a little bit of a one-sided one, but hey.
Nothing.
That's an average from your earlier roll, so that's fine. So no wounds from these guys, and lots of dead zombies. So it's fair to say that the American won that one. Killed every zombie, squashed them, kicked them out of the ruins.
Just to be sure,
yes,
my tough doesn't activate in melee,
That's a very, very good question. That's an
important question because...
It's a very, very good question.
You might be trying to knock them away and just they're getting in the way a bit more.
I would argue that they're getting in there and they're actually punching them in the heads and really brutal stuff. So I would argue that it wouldn't count. But
so basically you're just going...
Okay.
Zombie.
Let's have a look. So units with a tough special role may have a number of ways of resisting damage, most commonly through effective armor and natural tolerance to pain, which is the one for this one.
Yeah.
So they roll a d6 every time an opponent equal to or over their damage value. They ignore it on a 5+, so it does count for everything. Oh. The only way it can get ignored is if you get hit with a damage penetration of +2 or more. So the heavier weapons will just
shred you.
Yeah.
But obviously, with it being combat, you need to save. Even if you lose by one, you lose your unit. So you have to save every single one of these. So 8 rolls.
If
they're all 5+, then you draw the combat.
Okay, so that's how many I'm rolling.
It's a good spot, though. Yeah, brand new rules. It's always good to double check when they come into play. Mm-hmm. So
make sure I have my hit. Okay.
So, go, Justin.
Good luck.
As Alessio would say, time for some spawny rules. Nope.
Nope.
None of them.
Nope.
None of them.
So, there was a bit of a tussle. Unfortunately, zombie paste was made. So. Mm-hmm. Every last zombie is dead here. John, you have total control.
You've got a D6 consolidation move. Now, you probably don't want to use all of it. You can just take up, move an inch or so in terrain if you really want to, or you can roll the dice and see how far you can go.
That'll go away.
Your choice entirely. You might as well roll the dice and see what
options
you
can roll the dice, yeah.
And one important thing, Chez, take my zombies dice out of the bag.
Correct.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
I get my first unit kill.
Huzzah.
Yeah. Yes.
A little trophy. I need to make a little trophy rack, I can say. You can put objective value, you can put dice on. Mm. Right, so we'll roll the dice.
So you got a four-inch consolidation move. Yeah. So
4 inches will basically consolidate into the hedge.
Okay.
I think.
Really? You're moving away from your objective?
This is here.
Yeah, but you're in hardcover.
If you, there are two options. You either stay in and around the hardcover, or you hop just outside the hardcover but in front of the hedge, meaning that you can assault away from it. Because if you're in the ruins, you're not going to be able to assault out. Mm. So it is a genuine good question. So
they're going to hop the hedge.
Okay,
I think so. We'll just bring them to the other side of the hedge.
Yep. Okay. Now I think you can probably keep some of them just behind the hedge soft cover because we're ignoring that for movement.
Yeah.
So keep a couple in there. It's just the fact that you don't want to be in the ruins.
Not in the weeds.
Perfect.
Okay. Next up.
Good. Oh, there we go. Heavy infantry, elite infantry doing exactly what you wanted them to do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
So next up, another American dice.
Right. This unit will advance.
Okay, so they are under fire. So they need a command test first. I believe they've only got one pin.
Yep.
So they're down to an 8. 8 or less. Can you do it?
No.
11. So they go to ground. So
put
the change the order to down.
Mm-hmm.
And leave the pin on them.
Unfortunate.
So there we go. Could have spelt doom.
Mm-hmm.
Germans. How do you react to this?
So my options at the minute, I can either tie up this final flank on my side and just get it completely safe.
Yeah.
I can turn my turret and fire point blank at this.
Risky with the pins on you, but
Or I can turn this and try and fire here to try and take these guys down before they get at me next turn. They've already went, so I'm not worried. I have more than enough firepower here, and I'm hoping if I need to, I can get a reaction again.
Yep.
These guys, I'm just keeping where they're at for now because I think I'm going to move them up shortly and shoot here.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't need to worry about that yet. So my biggest threat is your mech. So what's going to happen is the turret is going to turn.
Yep.
I'm going to take the test, and I'm going to try for a fire order.
Fire order. Okay. So 2d6. Now you're at -2 because you have 2 pins on you from your damage from the last one. So
do commanders work for vehicles?
Not in this case. No, you're not close enough either. So
damn. Okay. So. That'll be 6.
6, which is 8, which is a pass. So you lose one pin marker. Exactly.
I don't know why the Thunderbirds theme tune came into my head.
I hope you put it in my head too. Right, so 1 dice.
Okay.
You're going to be at your basic penetration value for this because it's such a light walker.
Yeah, but I have to roll the hit first.
To roll the hit. And an extra -1 because of the pin marker.
Yeah. So point blank.
Yep. Cancels out.
-1 for the pin. So I'm just on a 3.
3s. Any dodge?
Nope.
No.
No, it's a hit.
Yep.
Mm.
So I'm on a 4+.
Absolutely. Now, I think it's probably worthwhile perhaps looking at how you might be allowed to react.
Oh.
So you can open up and do a firefight if you want, but you've only got a heavy machine gun, so you won't be doing it on the side anyway, so don't worry.
Yeah.
It's again, just got to try and think about the new reactions that you can do each time.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, see if you
what's
roll
its armor?
It's armor 7.
Armor 7 with my 4, so I need...
three or more to do something.
And two.
No, nada.
No, nothing this time. So you do still take a pin marker.
Mm-hmm.
So you've been hit.
Yeah.
Yep.
So but not squished.
Not squished. We're just a little uneasy now.
Yeah. Well, that's unfortunate.
The cockpit just rang like a bell. It was like, whoa.
That's the good thing about the anti-grav is actually just as good against the Sherman as it is against that kind of thing. Or, you know, even...
See, it's what I was discussing. With that nice plus four to begin with, and then when it's on heavier targets, it gets better.
Yep.
It's not sitting there going, I'm amazing against everything. It's just going, I'm nice. I'm level across the board. I can hurt everything.
Quite cool. Okay, next dice out. It's another German one.
Another German one.
So, okay. Your infantry is all a bit bunched up at the back. They haven't got huge amounts of... target, but
what's going to happen is these guys
are
just going to get an advance order. So where's advance? There's advance. So I need to roll my test.
And your command section's nearby, so...
Nine or less. Seven, they like it.
They like that. So they're going to take the pin marker off and advance up to 6 inches.
Yeah, so they're just going to here, and they're just going to unload everything into John's heavy squad.
Yeah, I believe the heavy squad there is now definitely the pivot of your entire... Yeah. Game plan, but they're so tough. I wouldn't be surprised if they keep they take all this on the chin.
So I've got nine guys there with rifles, so that's nine dice.
You lost your LMG, didn't you? Yeah, good point. So nine dice. Now you've moved, and there's definitely, I believe we said about holding them around the hedge, so we're going to give them soft cover. They're not in the ruins anymore.
Okay.
So it's going to be minus two.
So sixes?
Sixes. Fives.
Fives?
Yeah.
You sure?
Threes down to fives.
Okay, threes to fives.
Absolutely. So fives to hit.
Got one. Yeah. One dice needs rerolled.
Yeah.
Nope. So one hit.
So you do take a pin.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's the most I really want to do to them right now, is just make them a little harder to activate.
And now, so one dice rolling to wound, and they're resilient, as we said earlier, so it's a six.
Yeah.
No. Yep. So another one that goes. So there we go. So again, you really need some almost anti-tank weaponry, so your autocannon... Autistic cannons and things like that is is the
but
way to go.
I know they've activated this turn, so I'm not too worried. So I'm picking my moments and seeing if I can whittle them down and hurt them a little first.
Good shout. Okay, Americans. So again, you've still got the walker over there, but there's nothing you can really react to it. So you've got a couple of units down here.
Yeah.
Your walker being one of them, and then your ravaged infantry.
You could walk
section.
Away from my tank.
No.
Yeah. Come on, he's an inch away at the moment. He's going to not walk away. He's going to get hold of it and rip it to pieces again.
Yeah.
Yep, so I'm going to try again on the tank.
Okay, so on the tank again.
So a 2d6 command tech to make sure he
comes
can make
down as a, it comes down as a run order when it's
yes,
a,
it is a run assault. Order for an assault.
So 2d6 for the pin.
Yep. And so you need to roll an 8 or less, which you do.
Yeah.
And
so you'll lose
the pin.
Mm-hmm.
And then the same as last time, guys. You're rolling 3 dice versus 1.
Yep. Okay, so
we're against the three again. So you're on minus one on these. So just the one gets through this time.
Yeah.
But you do roll again on the damage table.
Yeah. No, just to clarify, I want to make sure we're doing this right. Okay.
Yes.
So because I'm heavier than him.
Yep.
He gets a minus one. I want to make sure there's no other stuff on top of that.
Yeah, well, the best he can do is a superficial damage. So like in the last one, that's why you came down so badly on the chart. You're rolling. It's not.
Yep.
Destroy in one go, you're causing a huge amount of pins. So an extra pin for winning the combat and getting through.
Yep.
And then a roll on the chart to see if we cause a whole bunch more pins.
Oh, five.
So that's another immobilized. So it's another pin.
Okay.
It still stays there. So you're now back up to three pins. This is really, you know, you're tearing chunks out of this thing.
No. This reminds me of a story that John once told me about a troop of Shermans who ran out of AP shells.
Yeah.
And they came up against a German vehicle. So they were firing their HE at this thing, right? They fired so much HE at it that the concussion is actually what took out the crew.
Wow.
Yeah. It was a group of tanks against the Tiger, and they realized that their AP would do nothing, so they just unloaded their HE stock on it, so they hit it about 145 times.
Oh, I can imagine somebody painting one of these as like a Hulk smashing tanks to pieces, just doing that concussing everyone.
At the minute, it's just bong, bong, bong. Do you have a moment to talk?
I'm
staying in here. I'm staying buttoned up.
I'm putting dents in that thing. Like the hatches aren't opening properly anymore. The crew are getting banged
around. The driver's probably just sitting there with a fist-shaped lump out of the tank beside his head going...
Yeah, it's going to be pretty ineffectual for the rest of the game now.
Mm. Yeah.
So, no, fantastic work from the walker. Okay, next up.
Okay.
Another American dice.
Oh.
So time to start thinking about pinning over on this side. So again, your choices are, you've got a unit here with one pin on them. So they'd be on a 9 or less test because the HQ section, or a no dice test. You don't even need the test for the HQ itself.
Yeah. I think, can I issue a run from these guys, or do they have to advance?
Not from where they are. So yeah, it'd be advancing. You can only ever really do run orders when you're in the open.
Yeah.
Any kind of terrain you're up and down.
All right. They'll advance then,
okay.
I think.
Okay.
And they'll do their 6-inch advance.
6 inches across to the side of these guys.
They're just going to join up with this unit, I think.
Yep. So again, stay an inch away. Make sure you're an inch away. You might even be able to get a shot out. So if you come 6 inches to here, you can shoot with the ones that can shoot past.
Mm-hmm.
So keep them across. Go on, get yourself right across. Give yourself every chance.
Yeah. So let's get to there.
Yeah, and make sure this is marked onto the correct.
Yeah.
This one. Because it's not your command squad.
In the same way as taking casualties with you and the right infantry, to take the right pins with you as well. Okay, so you've got a couple of guys there that can shoot now. Mm-hmm. So it's always worthwhile making sure you get the maximum amount out of that.
Okay. Yeah. So we're going to have two rifle shots.
Yeah. Now you're within short range. Mm-hmm. So you're within your 12. You don't get the minus for moving. So it's just the hard covers. You're actually now down to fives.
Five.
Now, obviously, you can react again here if you wish. Again, it's a two dice test to see if you do it. But it's an interesting one in this one, because obviously there's so much hard cover and everything in between you and him. You may or may not be worth it. Depends if you're happy with them right there or whether they want to actually move into the objective area.
I'm quite happy with them there because they're on the objective, or at least I assume they're on the objective there.
Yep, I think. Well, they're as close as nobody else is closer.
So yeah, I'm going to go for it.
So two dice test again.
10 or less, because command squad is in range.
Absolutely.
They manage it with a 9.
Right. And so they get their dice out and they do a fire order as well.
Awesome.
So you get all your dice together and repeat back with the fire. So you're all on fives.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll roll first. I've got
4 for that.
So you get a hit.
Yep.
That's a pin onto the German unit.
Yep.
And a test to see if you've killed one. 4 plus to kill one.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a 6, so it might be special. And it is not, so just a regular guy.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I'll get to shoot back.
You do.
Hello.
Nice.
Well,
so 5 hits, so 1 pin marker for you guys.
So that's 5.
Beautiful.
And then 4s to wound.
Yep, 4s to wound. Might manage to wipe out his command squad this turn, which could be useful for me.
Could be.
There's 6 in there.
Well, there's lots and lots of wounds.
Yep. So, a 1, so it's not exceptional.
But 4 wounds on a 3-man unit is enough to wipe them.
Yeah.
So I'm afraid the dice comes across.
Oh,
so, but it is. I mean, now these guys are going to have to put the pressure on their own, I'm afraid.
Yeah.
Or maybe the walker might have to.
We see what I'm seeing has happened here is, I've really sewn up this side by some good shooting and some good reactions.
Yeah.
This side, John has his heavy hitters, so I mean, like, depending on how this game goes, he might be fit just to swing right across here
and just. Well, he's got another full squad on the far side that can leapfrog into the objective.
Possibly.
And then these ones. So yeah, it's still interesting. It's certainly swinging around, isn't it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right.
Okay. So, next one up is Germans. You've got your HQ section and you've got your walker.
Yeah. My walker. Yeah, my walker is just going to stand and shoot because I don't want to get any minuses.
Sure.
So from where he is, he's just going to point blank into this unit.
Yeah.
All right.
So now, do you want to go for the light anti-tank, which is a +4, which would be killing on 2s, or for the automatic cannon, which will give you an extra shot, but it's not quite as strong.
So the auto cannon's 2 shots.
It is.
Mm. I think I'm going to go for the 1 shot with the easier kill.
Okay.
So I assume it's just on 3.
You're point blank in a bit of soft cover, so 3s.
Okay.
It's a 1, so there we go. Just goes to show that you can kill things with 1 shot, you can also just miss them.
Basically, the gun depression wasn't quite there.
I think you're absolutely right.
Just straight over their heads into the ruin.
But you identified the fact that they were such a huge threat that you've left yourself exposed. It didn't matter. It's worth the risk in that one.
Yeah.
Okay, so 2 dice left in the bag. 1 is American.
Yeah.
So that's those infantry.
Fire order. Okay.
Not surprising. So
on who? Because I've got my regular squad here, and I've got my command squad at the back.
It's going to be your regulars.
I think that's a good choice.
Because they can't react back. Yeah. Okay.
They've got one. The regular squad has got a pin on them at the moment. Adding more to that and hoping that they fail at some point is great.
But I have a pin as well.
You do. So 2 dice, needing 8 or less. Yep, they're absolutely fine. And then taking off one of the pins.
Mm-hmm.
I think they've only got one anyway.
Yep.
So 4 shots. You are in short range, so you're going to be on 5s with the hard cover.
One.
That's a hit.
So that's then, two pins on that unit.
A 4 plus to kill one, and you do kill another one.
Okay. Oh, actually, I forgot to take the guy off that time.
Oh, so there you, we go.
So there are two guys that need to come off from that unit. Mm-hmm. So, regular guy, and regular guy. Because I don't want to drop my other stuff, because I actually do have some Panzerfaust in those units.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay, and then last but not least is the German HQ section.
Yeah. German HQ...
This is a great thing about this. You're getting down to eye level now. Real decisions. Sometimes it's obvious when you've got easy open shots, but sometimes you really have to think about it, because you can shoot through your friendly units.
Yep, I'm giving them an advance.
Yep.
And that's just going to let me shuffle them all across.
Okay.
So that they can actually see without my unit blocking the line. So they will take a minus one, but that's okay.
Yep, that's absolutely fine. They are just over 12 inches, so they're a long range.
Okay.
And there's definitely walls and things in the way, so it's hardcover. Uh-huh. So you're going to be on sixes.
Okay, so three shots, yeah?
Three shots on sixes. And there's no
nothing.
Hits. So,
oh, that's such a shame. I got two fives there.
Yeah, okay. That's the thing. Because you had to move to get into the right position, because you're just slightly too far away, but any closer, you're going to risk getting wiped out straight away.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It's always a tactical option.
Yeah, right. So is that turn done?
Well, that's end of turn three. Yeah. So rattling through.
And five. So we've both lost one unit here. We're both fighting for like crazy.
I've lost two.
Yep.
You lost
the second. The second unit died just down here.
Yep. Oh yeah. Sorry.
But you know, we've still got a couple of a couple of things fighting for this objective. A couple of things fighting for this objective. Even though it feels that. So if one of you can steal both of the objectives, then obviously you're going to win. So,
yeah.
That's what you're aiming for this turn. Mm-hmm. Okay. So start turn four.
Yep.
We are going to jump straight in and go with an American.
All right.
So what is, you've got a heavily pinned panzer, which may or may not be important this turn. You've got some heavy infantry, which are looking threatening.
Yeah, I'm worried here. I'm assuming my spider mech might just be about to get its leg ripped off.
Now, it could do. I mean, there is a chance. They are tank hunters, so they can go in and give it a go. Mm. But is it the most important? The mech itself can't take the objective. It's not an infantry unit. So, it's a tough one. I think the infantry on this side are equally as a viable an option.
So at these?
Yeah.
Possibly. And then you've also got this squad up here, which you might be able to jump into the objective.
Yeah, potentially. Right. No guts, no glory, right?
Uh-huh.
So my heavy infantry is going to activate, and they're going to make a run move.
Yep. Okay.
So they're going to head straight for this unit here.
Okay.
Eep.
Eep, eep, indeed. So you're going to go for an assault?
Yes.
Yep, okay. So that's why they came out of the ruins, to give them that option to do that.
Yep.
And obviously we're not including the hedgerows.
So we're so kind of bungling over them.
Now you get to react in this case. There's another reaction in this one called escape.
Escape.
So if you, again, pass your test, you're a bit too far away from your HQ to use that. If you pass, you can then make a full move backwards.
Right.
Which means he's probably going to be left out in the middle of nowhere, but you're forced completely out of this entire turn, away from the objectives, and it's pretty much as good as doing that. So the other option is to stand and fire.
I'm going to stand and shoot.
Okay.
Because I've still got nine guys there, which it's a reasonable odds of actually doing something.
Sure. Mm-hmm. So two dice, see if you pass your test.
Yep.
And they do, they got no pins on them, luckily. So they do that. So all those dice, and again, you're pretty much at point blank.
Yep.
The thing. So you're on threes to hit.
Nice. Miss.
Almost
miss.
Not quite yet.
Miss.
And then a six is to wound.
None.
No.
And I assume no pins for those hits?
No, well, it would be a pin, but first thing you need to do, sorry.
Just test
to
for
make
them.
A test to see if they go in. We completely forgot about that.
Yeah.
There we go.
Gonna help.
Six, they're fine.
So that would have removed that pin, but they took a pin on the way in.
But it does matter because you're when you get to come. But anyway, so remove it. So away they go.
Away they go, and so here comes the pin.
They make it in. They got plenty of rooms. So they can all go in.
Yeah, you can make that not a problem.
Yep.
Line them up on the hedgerow.
That looks so imposing, having this huge armored infantry towering over these guys.
If I fire a Panzerfaust at those, would that help?
It would have helped, yes. You can always choose to fire the hands off. Yeah, well, you get plus four, don't you? Or plus five or six, whatever. Yeah.
Well, we'll see what happens, because one of us is about to die.
Yeah. okay, so straight into it. Now it's... we're not counting these as obstacles, so it's simultaneous.
Yeah.
Sorry. but not counting those obstacles. So you get to fight first because he counts as open.
John will get his full 10.
10, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Eep, eep, eep.
Eep, indeed. And then killing on fours.
Yep.
Lots of dead.
One, two, three. Yeah, three.
Not as many as he could have had.
Yep. So three guys are dead. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So six attacks back, needing sixes.
Oh, this hurts.
They're so tough, aren't they?
They're ridiculously tough.
Nothing.
And obviously at that point you go, oh, you can't win that. You're just basically holding him by the scruff of his neck, like shouting surrender at him.
Yeah, so my entire unit here goes home, and their dice comes out of the bag.
It does. They haven't acted this turn. Okay, so that's another victory token. And again, you get your D6 consolidation to try and not leave yourself in the open.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, now, John, you could be moving up through here to come into the soft underbelly.
Yeah, well, I remember Churchill saying that once about Italy, and it proved wrong. So,
yeah.
My D6 is
one inch. You don't really get much choice to do anything at all.
I so, shuffle.
Yeah.
But I'm going to shuffle back.
Yeah. Behind the, take the hedgerow, bit of soft cover.
Yeah.
Toughest infantry on the table.
Mm-hmm.
Hiding.
Mm-hmm.
No, very good.
Hiding very wisely.
Yeah. Okay, so, Germans.
Okay. What I need to do, I need to stop focusing on that Coyote. So that I'm going to activate and try and activate.
Sure.
And give it a fire order.
Now this is a very risky one because you're at minus three.
Turret returns.
Yep.
And is going to try and shoot them.
Okay.
So minus three, I need six or less, yeah?
Yep, absolutely.
Okay.
Can he do it?
Oh.
It's been pretty reliable so far, this tank.
Oh,
no.
Nine, nothing.
Now, obviously, vehicles usually make a retreat move, but you're immobilized, so you just stay where you are and go.
Yeah, down. And go down.
Yeah.
Which.
Yeah. Next up, straight to the Americans.
Mm-hmm.
Americans got
also,
the upper
John,
hand on.
Don't forget to bring your dice with you.
Yeah.
Well, it was nearly there.
Confusion.
It was nearly there.
Nearly, but not quite.
Nearly
okay,
there.
So.
Yeah.
All right. Infantry that are pinned at the far side.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Infantry that are pretty.
Beaten.
Yeah, they're pretty beaten, but, mm-hmm. you know, they're in a good firefight over here. Or the Coyote.
We're going to try with this infantry again, I think.
Okay.
Okay.
Try and get them into some better cover onto the objective. So,
yeah, I think so. Yeah. So we're going to try and issue in advance, I think.
Sure.
Is there, and then we'll take 2d6. One pin.
Down to an 8.
No.
11 again. They stay where they are. So at the moment, you're still fighting over it. So with one turn left after this, you're going to have to either withdraw the heavy infantry back or with that. So,
one turn left after this? Are we not in turn four?
We're in turn four. We'll see if there's a fifth turn.
Okay.
So at the end, one turn left possibly after this.
Okay.
So,
okay.
Yep. Yeah.
Okay.
So, fooled.
No!
It's an American dice.
Damn you, Chez, and your drawing abilities.
So this is pretty much not in good places right now.
Yeah, you could just walk away from it now.
The crew aren't happy.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. The crew aren't happy.
Now, you can only assault in a straight line like you did from there across to there. So you can't actually declare an assault over here, but you can run around and do some horrible shooty.
Yeah, because you've got the heavy machine gun and medium machine gun on this.
Mm-hmm. Yep. What does he do?
Well, it's important
I
clear this objective out.
I think I've annoyed your army taking that Sherman out so early. They're just going, you took our Tesla tank. No!
He's ran up to it and just slapped that Panzer around a bit and went, that's enough!
He's always that driver owed get me out. Money!
Get out!
All right, so the Mac would probably need to make an advance then.
Uh-huh.
I think so, walking around the side and opening fire, almost certainly.
Or
going for the other walker.
But he could assault the other walker, couldn't he?
No, you can't go in a straight line through the ruins or anything.
Yeah, so you wouldn't make it.
Yeah. Okay.
I may have to be cunning here.
Let's advance it then.
Okay.
I think. And he's going to do his 9-inch.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Oh, you're coming to play with my other squad. Thunderbar.
Clump, clump, clump.
Yeah.
Point blank range.
Yeah. You have moved, which does that make a difference for the
it
mech?
It does, yeah. So it'll be a minus one, so three's basic, moved fours, and they're all in and around the hard cover,
mm-hmm.
so sixes. So would you want to go for four dice or three dice with a plus one penetration?
Four dice.
Four
okay.
Dice.
So
yep.
Needing sixes.
Yep.
Lovely.
And there's a six,
there's
a pin marker. That's always good.
And then a 4+ to...
4+ to kill one.
Yep.
Uh-huh. Another...
No.
No. But so it's no another kills. Pin. It's quite important to get that pin through.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So that's the walker now has moved away from the tank and is less effective against infantry, but mm-hmm. the Germans have a chance to come back.
Yep. Hmm. Okay, I don't need to worry about that now. Don't need to worry about those now. Don't need to worry about those now. So, I'm going to activate my command section.
Sounds good.
Mm-hmm. And I have... This is me trying to be sneaky and trying to steal both objectives. So, they're getting a run order.
Yep.
And they are going to blitz 12 inches.
Yep.
Up so, to that objective.
So, stop. Just in around it. You can't go into the ruins with the run, but you can
stop. That means any shooting they're taking from there is going to be from hard cover.
Yep.
Which I think is going to be the clever way to do this.
Mm-hmm. Sounds good to me.
Yep.
Okay, so next up, what have they got left? Americans. Mm-hmm. So now, obviously, is that your last dice? I believe it is.
It is.
So you've got infantry section here. So your new threat, you can walk and take some easy shots, or you can pour more fire into these guys. Mm-hmm. What do they want to do?
It's important that I put pressure on them. So this is going to advance across.
Sure. Mm-hmm. So advance order, no pins on you this turn, so you can do what you like.
This is just me making a gambit.
Well, you have to. I think that's absolutely right. I think. That's that. Now you can shoot through your own units. So you can put them in a nice little 2x2 formation there.
Yep.
Shoot straight past there.
Yeah. You're keen.
Okay, and your ranged target is what now? Is it under 6 or is it over 6? Because that could be even better for you. Well under 6.
Under 6, definitely.
Yep. So 4 shots, mm-hmm. a point blank range. No minuses for moving because your carbine abilities.
Yep. I am hunkering in the hedge.
You are hunkering in the hedge. Okay, we'll give you soft cover. We did for the other guys when they were hunkering in the hedge, so that's absolutely fine. So you will be on 3s. Point blank shooting and hedgerow. Two hits.
Okay, that'll be a pin.
To pin, and then 2 rolls to wound, 4s. One goes down.
One dead. So I'll just have regular guy die.
But importantly, it's not a 10.
Mm. Yes, and now it's 2-man team. Does that make a difference
it
now
makes
as well?
It's slightly harder to hit them, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Awesome. Black dice. Okay. So what's going to happen now, I'm going to activate this unit, and I'm going to fire both my Panzerfaust.
Nice.
Straight at the coyote. Yeah. Because if I can clear this out, I'll be happy.
Yeah, absolutely. So nothing else can harm it because it's enclosed. So so 2 shots at point blank. Now, there is ruins between you and them. It's not one way. So we'll have to put, obviously, a harder shot in there. So you're looking at 6s.
Okay.
But you are point blank, so 5s.
Okay.
So 5s to hit, 2 Panzerfaust. Can he do it? Mm. No.
Off into the distance.
Sadly, that was
damn
great thing. In fact, it's probably a good job because we needed to do a command test for them.
Actually, let's do the morale test.
We're getting very
first.
Carried away, but we would have been
do the morale test first.
Yeah.
So it's -3.
Yeah.
5.
Which they pass. Yep. So they get
So they would have shot, they would have missed.
Yep.
And then your last unit, which will be your
my little mech.
Yep.
So my little mech is just going to do an advance. I'm just going to completely ignore these guys. Mm-hmm. It's going to advance 9 inches to here. And with its light anti-tank gun, it's also going to shoot your coyote to try mm-hmm. and see if I can clear that up.
Oh, nice. So the light anti-tank gun is 1 shot.
Yep.
It's pretty clear from there, to be honest. So it's just 4s because you've moved.
A 2. Damn.
Haven't blown it out this time.
My Germans are getting very tired.
Well, apparently so.
Okay, right. So, let's clear up the table.
Yep.
Have a look.
Bring the dice back in.
Bring the dice back in, yeah.
So that's 3 for me, I think.
4.
1, 2, 3, yeah.
Yep.
Yep.
Oh, you're...
Oh, yeah.
We're back. 4 against 4.
Yeah.
So, right. Now, let's see if there's another turn. So, turn 5.
Uh-huh.
And there is! So we're on to the turn 5. So at the moment, the Germans are easily holding this one.
Yeah.
This might chew it up.
Yeah. Well, this I quite like the look of. I quite like the look of this.
So now the Americans have actually got a problem of which one to try and take back. Mm-hmm. So, on to turn 5.
Yeah.
Germans.
Oh, okay.
What do you do? Does the little 2-man team hunker down even tighter? Mm. Do you try and pin the units that are coming after you?
I think... What I need to do more than anything right now is I'm going to try and activate, well, I am going to activate my light mech.
Yep.
And I'm going to have it just stand and fire.
Sure.
to get a 3-up onto the coyote, because it's a big threat here. I want to get it clear.
Yeah, absolutely. If it clears you out of this objective, you're in trouble.
So one shot on a 3, yeah?
Sounds good. It's a hit.
Mm. Nice.
It's a +4 against an armor of 7, so you only need a 3 to do something.
Okay.
No, unlucky, but it is a pin.
Yep, it is a pin.
So that's taking a pin.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that's, could take it out of the game.
If I'm lucky.
If you're lucky. So again, Germans, another unit.
Does this have a hull-mounted MMG?
It does. It's got a forward-facing one there. So if it wants to, it can point-blank shoot that.
I'm going to try a fire order.
Why not? So you're down to 2 pins right now?
I'm on 3.
3?
So
2d6 test, you need 6 or less.
Does the command team activate now?
It's within 6, so yep. So 7.
Yes.
Yeah, so you take one off.
Yeah.
So you're on point blank. So you should be on 2s, but you're actually up to 4s because of the pins.
Yeah.
So, the ears of the machine gunner are still ringing, and he's like, just
there's something moving in front of the tank!
Fire!
3 hits.
3 hits. Outrageously nice. Good. So a pin on that unit, and then 4s to kill them.
Let's see if you kill them first.
Yeah.
Well, there's 4 guys there. So 2 die.
2 dead. See if there's one special damage.
Mm-hmm. Yep, one exceptional.
Yeah.
No.
So two more guys dead. You do need to test at -1.
Yep. Yes.
It's half your squad is gone.
Mm-hmm.
So it could make all the difference there.
That's the test now.
Yep, straight away. 2D6. Immediate 2d6. And you passed.
That's fine.
So
that's fine.
It's fine, he says. But yeah. No,
well, that was a really nice little cinematic moment.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You know, just the machine gunner going, they're moving!
You never run in front of a tank when it's pointing its machine gun at you.
Yeah, there's that.
Yeah. Okay, so you've got a number of options here. Now you're taking a lot of pins. The only thing that isn't pinned on your force now
is the elite.
Is the elite.
Yeah.
So the question is, do they want to risk everything to try and clear this side out?
Yeah.
Or risk everything to try and pull back and take that when your other options are over there? It's a tough one. That's a really tough choice.
Mm.
It's a very grisly looking fight right now, I have to say.
It's getting very bloody down there. Mm. Let's activate these elite fellas and let's get rid of that light mech before it takes the coyote down completely.
Sure. Well, it's the last in the game and it's already acted.
Yeah.
So it's not actually going to do anything else.
One less. Unless I want to try and bypass the coyote and get in with these.
Well, I'd say you do have a reasonably straight line there to assault if you want.
What do you think?
I would give it to you because it's pretty much a straight shot across the hedge.
He's being nice, so if you want to take it.
Yeah, if he's being nice to me, I'll take it.
Of course I'm being nice. It's a fun game.
I think he wants to stop you.
He does.
Yeah, yeah. I think so. It's great. There we go. So an assault move around there.
Yep. I will stand and shoot with 2.
And you're at -1 on the pin, so 2d6 test to see if you can. Which you pass.
Yep.
Pull your thing out and do a fire order.
Uh-huh.
And then, a couple of point blank shots. So you're looking at 4s.
Okay. 2 hits.
2 hits,
and then wounding on 6s. You could really do with a couple of wounds finally getting through.
One.
So one of them goes down. So, take one guy off. It's one less. So. Now, this is simultaneous because you do have cover in this case. So you're going to have 2 dice.
Yep.
Wounding on 6s against 8 dice.
Wounding on
4s. Smash.
Nothing. A lot.
Yes.
Enough to
kill those things.
Yep. And move me off there. Okay. So my command team is now dead. So their dice comes off the table and goes to you, John.
Yep. Absolutely.
So I could now do with a decent consolidation move.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Yep.
A 5.
Into the ruins.
We get in there quite easily, don't we?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we're all in there now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then we'll get rid of the pin marker to clear up the table from the dead squad.
And then
the next unit is the
Can I even hurt the coyote?
With whom?
I think these are my only guys left.
No, you fired your Panzerfaust, so...
Yeah. So I fired the Panzerfaust there. He's tried to shoot. So they can't really do anything.
So, you could put a couple of them onto the higher ground and shoot the couple of guys there. It's probably your best option.
It wouldn't really do much, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
So, really, it's just, I'm going
to
give
you
them...
You can go down. Now, it's interesting because you don't need a test. If you go to ground, it's a lot harder to obviously hit.
Yeah, I am just going to go down.
Okay.
I assume that doesn't count as a successful order, so I don't remove any pins.
You don't remove any pins. So there we go. So Americans.
Okay.
I think it's just Americans left now. So
yeah.
The Germans had their chance in this last turn.
I'm just gonna...
Your coyote could assault.
I don't wanna. I'm gonna let you have that.
Okay.
I'm actually gonna let you have that, because I've had to fight tooth and nail for this one.
Yeah. So, but it was a great fight. Yeah.
Yes.
The thing is, don't forget, at best, you can force him to take a test and maybe beat him in combat, but you're not actually going to capture it yourself with the coyote, so it is risking...
It's risking a lot.
...getting the coyote, blown up.
Mm. I'd be relying too much on the coyote clearing this infantry out and getting these guys...
Across, yeah.
...to get back, but I don't think they'll do that. Mm-hmm. Not with all the pin markers on everybody, so...
Are we looking at endgame?
I think we are. We're almost there.
We are nearly at endgame.
So,
I'm annoyed. I'm just going to go right back in at this tank again with the coyote, I think.
Why not? That sounds good. So, a test at minus one.
Yep. So, we'll issue the run and we'll do the test.
Uh-huh.
And it fails this time. Mm. It's like... Systems failing.
Running out of power. Turbine shutting down.
Yeah.
No, I think we are in endgame now. So your last two dice, you've got a squad over on the far side.
Yep.
Which aren't really going to do anything except for
they're under fire, and then the squad in the middle, which
also
really
under fire.
Either.
Not really going to do anything either.
If you're happy to look at the outcome,
I'm happy. Yeah, I'm going to look at the outcome of that. It's a good game regardless.
So first of all, well played. I think the specialist units. Did really
they
well.
Shined.
The zombies held the objective for the first couple of turns, and then the heavy infantry cleared everything out.
Yep.
The Tesla tank, you'll have to find out what that does next time. It gives you a good excuse to do it. But the gravity weapon blew this up, slowed some units down. Yeah, it got immobilized by the coyote, but it actually absorbed
it had
a lot of
shot
combat.
Here.
Yeah, and had a good shot there. And then the spider mech just running around all over the place, taking pot shots and
it really is an annoying little thing, to be honest with you. It's
so
not
cheap.
There to do a lot. Yeah. It's just there to constantly be putting pressure here, there, and wherever, and when you need it.
Absolutely. So the Americans definitely hold one objective. The Germans, without a doubt, hold the other.
Yeah.
Neither army's really broken. So let's go onto my note here, which I want to say. So I'm afraid, for me, the far objective is the real objective.
So
find the notes.
Just to be clear, here.
Yeah, where
the Americans
Allies
have taken it.
So
that's good, because we actually were. I don't feel bad about this loss, because I was fighting hard for that. I was taking risks for that.
Well, there was a real choice. I mean, over here, you put everything back to take that one back.
Yeah,
you could have quite just as easily walked around here, blown the snot out of these guys, and walked in and taken this one. In which case, you would have swapped objectives and you would have lost.
Yeah.
So
that was an interesting little scenario. I enjoyed that.
Mm-hmm. Very, very good.
So today the Allies get to retrieve their stolen intel.
Yep.
Guys, drop your comments below. That is Konflikt 47. I really, really enjoyed this game.
Yep.
Let us know what you think yourself. We'll move on, and we'll see you in another video.
Anime cyberpunk style meets skirmish combat in Infinity. Experience 8 high-tech factions and fight to control the human sphere at the Infinity Hub on beastofwar.com. In a world controlled by massive corporations, a steady aim and split-second decisions are needed for your Megacon to complete its goals. Begin your missions at the Mercs Hub on beastofwar.com.